Hey guys, it's me, Tori, and today I want to share with you why it's important for artists to ship their artwork from their home or their studio and how you can save money by doing so. You know, flashback a while ago when I wasn't shipping from my home, I spent and lost a lot of money on shipping. It was just something that I took on the chin, which I highly recommend you don't get comfortable doing because it can already be tough as it is being an artist, especially when you're looking to find your footing when it comes to your retailers and who you work with. Essentially, why you want to start working shipping from your home is because number one, it's less stressful. Number two, you can actually get it done way faster than waiting in line. So with COVID safety protocols and all that kind of stuff, you actually just ends up being safer in the long run. And the third reason why it actually saves you a lot of money. So the first thing you want to do to set yourself up from shipping from home is find access to cardboard boxes or wooden crates or shipping tubes that's going to fit the needs of your artwork and that's going to get your artwork there safely. So the reason why I was going to like the UPS so often is because they did such a phenomenal job with packing my artwork and it always arrived safe. There was rarely an issue. So I learned through YouTube videos, and my own research and just from watching how to, you know, ship it properly. Most of the time I ship with cardboard boxes with a lot of bubble wrap and fragile stickers and a lot of other like packing supporting situations. But if you do not have access to a wooden crate, that's obviously the best option because it's gonna arrive there the safest. It does end up costing you a lot more to number one make, but also the weight can be heavy, which definitely impacts the cost of shipping your artwork. So if you have access to crates, which I've done before, those are really great. And if your client wants to pay for them, I give them the option. And I also state that, hey, there could be damage if you choose the cardboard boxes. And then as an artist, I recommend you be really clear on what you're willing to do if it is damaged. So if you're willing to remake the work or refund your client or let them know that them choosing to ship through a cardboard box is their risk, then that's up to you as well. I personally do a little bit of both. Sometimes, depending on the situation, I will make them a new painting, but I don't usually refund because a lot of effort and work goes into your artwork and with mailing it can be tough. So I treat it on like a case by case basis. I ship a lot of my work in a mailing tube. I roll up my canvases. That's partly why I don't stretch them all the time before I work on them because a lot of my clients are overseas and the cost does go up. And it's also easier for them to say yes. If the shipping cost is $40 or $1,400, likelihood of your clients choosing the $40 option is great. I've even sometimes offered to pay for it to be stretched wherever the painting is being located to. And that ends up saving me some money as well. So once you have sourced your cardboard box or tubes, I usually get mine from the local UPS store. You can also order them in bulk from like Alibaba or Amazon, which isn't always so eco-friendly. So if you want to go a different route and support local, I highly recommend stopping by your local post office and seeing what they've got for you. Home Depot has some boxes that do work if you're in Canada or in the States, and I've also used those as well, and they usually come with some packing supplies. So get your supplies ready, okay? The next thing you want to do to be able to ship from your home is have a label printer and stickers. I purchased mine on Amazon. I believe it was about $100, and the stickers were maybe $20 to $40 just to have a bulk of them, because when you first learn how to print stickers and labels, you will make mistakes. So make sure you have a bulk of them to keep practicing. So then you have the parameters set up on your computer through online. Because I use Shopify as my platform, I can print my label through Shopify. It'll generate it for me based on the local post office rates, or I can go straight to the courier. Because I'm in Canada, I'll use Canada Post and plug it in manually. If I have a really large piece and I'm shipping it overseas, generally I get UPS to come and pick it up. Canada Post doesn't have that option. I would then have to take it to Canada Post to get picked up from the courier. So you want to have your label printer, and then the next thing you want to do is you want to have a scale. Why? Because it's going to more accurately weigh your artwork for you before you put it in the box or after you put it in the box to help you calculate the cost. If there are any errors, that's on you and you'll end up paying for them in the long run. So invest in a weight, in a scale. I think I got mine off Amazon as well, and it was under $100 and it weighs up to 100 pounds. most of my artwork. The heaviest I think I've ever sent was maybe 25 pounds, so we're in the clear. So basically, it's not that much, but it does save you a lot of your time and energy. It prevents you from having anxiety in the post office if you're anything like me when you're carrying a lot of artwork or just one big one and waiting in line and then getting to the counter and realizing that it's an oversized unit and they won't ship it or you have to pay a premium to do so. That stops it all from then and there, and you can find cheaper ways of doing it online that give you more options. If you sign up with your courier, they also have membership options that give you a discount. So I'm actually signed up with quite a few. Canada Post, I'm signed up with Percolator, I've signed up with UPS and DHL. And if I've ever sending something overseas, then I'll use one of the options and find the best rate for me. But in the long run, you're gonna save a lot of money because you're able to then pre-calculate how much each artwork would cost and then weave it into the price or as an option. Sometimes I even, once a piece is purchased, I have in the past reached out and said, hey, we'll calculate shipping after the piece is purchased. But I had found that I was dealing with such a quantity of artwork that was being purchased that I didn't want to go back and ask for more money from my clients who have already purchased from me. So what I did is I wove in the cost into the artwork itself. So when the clients go to check out, it's free. So they can't say no. It makes it much more difficult when you're offering something for free to your clients, especially artwork. So how do I do it? Well, if I'm selling a piece of artwork, a small piece, let's say, call it $400. If it is stretched, I know generally just based on my knowledge of researching and mailing artwork that sending that like within North America may cost anywhere between $30 to $75 on the slowest rate. And I'm always very clear. I have a profile on my website that says what my shipping policies are, what happens if something's damaged or doesn't get delivered, and the rate of how quick it's going to be delivered as well. So I'm really, really clear with that. So there's no question, and I can always refer my clients to that page if they ever have any questions as well. I know that if I'm mailing a 3-foot by 3-foot piece overseas, that's gonna cost me a couple hundred dollars through the UPS or even sometimes up to $1,000 depending on where it's going. So if that's the case, then I will contact my buyer and I will let them know, hey, I'm actually gonna send this roll to you. I will sometimes offer, like I said, to have it stretched when it gets there. But if they don't put up a fuss, then I will usually just leave it in their hands to deal with it afterwards. So there you have it. I hope that was really helpful for you guys when it comes to learning how and what you need to start shipping from home. If you actually want to see how I ship on a step-by-step process, fill out a comment, let me know. I'm more than happy to take you into that option of how I work. But for now, this is just a general oversense of why it's important for artists to learn how to ship from their home. And if I can make this job easier for you, please let me know what else you want to discuss by commenting below and liking and sharing this video and even subscribing to my channel. Okay, thanks for your time and we'll see you later. Bye.